This is the BBC.
This podcast is supported by advertising outside the UK.
From the gas pump to the grocery store, inflation is everywhere. Seriously, make it stop. Thankfully, there's one company out there that's giving you a much-needed break. It's Mint Mobile. As the first company to sell premium wireless service online only, Mint Mobile lets you order from home and save a ton, with phone plans starting at just $15 a month. All plans come with unlimited talk and text, plus high-speed data delivered on the nation's largest 5G network. To get your new wireless plan for just $15 a month and get the plan shipped to your door for free, go to mintmobile.com/switch. That's mintmobile.com/switch.
BBC Sounds. Music, radio, podcasts. To the top on Radio 2.
It's the last 10 to the top of the week, and we say a very good morning to Steve Oliver, who is in Chelmsford. Morning, Steve.
Morning, Gary. How you doing?
I'm doing great, thank you. Why do your friends describe you as a walking jukebox?
Oh, that's a bit embarrassing, to tell you the truth, Gary, but I've got quite a wide range of musical trivia knowledge, and hopefully I'm not going to get shot in the foot by these questions I'm being asked today, because I've got a good knowledge of music up until mid-90s. So anything up until then, I'm quite good at. But anything after that, not so good at. But yeah, that's why they call me that, the walking jukebox.
So you're setting yourself up for a big fall now, you realise.
Exactly. Yeah, I just hope it doesn't all fall apart, I tell you. Yeah.
So you like playing snooker and pool?
Yes, yeah, I enjoy playing snooker and pool. I enjoy watching the World Championship snooker
the last couple of weeks. Yeah, it was very exciting. Interestingly enough, your opponent today, Matt, is also a pool player as well.
So, oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Battle of the pool players today.
It is.
Well, I wish you lots of luck.
Thank you.
I hope you have a good round. Remember, you have a joker you can play anytime you like.
Okay, will do.
Do you have a system, by the way, with your joker?
Not really, no. No, I'm just going to see how I feel. If I get a run of questions right, then I'll probably play my joker. But if it gets to the 10th question and I haven't done very well, then I'll just have to try my best on the 10th question. But we'll see how it goes.
Good luck, Steve. Here comes your 10 to the top. Question one. Who's the lead singer of the Foo Fighters?
Not a good start. No, I don't know.
Dave Grohl, lead singer of the Foo Fighters. No worries, plenty of time left. Which 1990 number one song by Madonna had the same title as a famous fashion magazine?
Vogue.
Yep. You're up and running. 2 points on this question. There was a new number one this week in 1992. Name the group who covered this KC and the Sunshine Band hit. Who's performing that?
I think that was KWS.
Yes. KWS, and of course the song was Please Don't Go, originally performed by KC and the Sunshine Band. 3 points on the next question. Although it finally got to number one in 2022, in what year did Running Up That Hill by Kate Bush first reach the top three?
Oh, that was in the 80s, 1987.
1985, I'm afraid.
Okay.
All right, let's start the run again. Which group made their chart debut in 1990 with Unbelievable?
EMF.
Yeah. Okay, 2 points now. What kind of colours did Cyndi Lauper sing about on her 1986 hit single?
True Colours.
True Colours is correct. 3 points coming up now.
I'll play the joker, Gary.
OK. Potentially 6 points this question is worth. Listen to the chorus from this 1979 song. It was the biggest of three top 40 hits for this band, but can you name them? That this is the time, this is the time for action. Who's that band?
No, I've got no idea. I'll say the Boys, I don't know.
Medium drop.
No, okay.
It was Secret Affair.
Oh, yeah, I should have got that. Yeah, should have got
the
that.
The song was Time for Action. What a shame. Never mind.
Yeah.
1 point. The 2009 hit Empire State of Mind was a collaboration that brought together rapper Jay-Z and which singer?
Alicia Keys?
Yeah. Was Alicia Keys. 2 points. On his top 10 hit in 1973, Paul Simon said, take me to the what?
Take me to the Mardi Gras.
Yeah. It's a brilliant song, that. Love that song. Mm. So, you have 3 points available for your final question. Who scored consecutive top 10 hits in 1981 with the songs D-Days and Will You?
Hazel O'Connor.
Yes. Well done. So, you ended up with 12 points.
Oh, not bad.
It's all right, isn't it?
Yeah. It's okay. Yeah, it's okay. I'll settle for that.
It very nearly was a lot more, but I guess it's just the way the questions run. But you clearly do know your stuff, Steve, so don't be too disappointed. And you never
know.
Thanks, Gary. 12 points might be a winning score. We'll chat with Matt Beresford right after this.
Hello, United Kingdom. This is Eurovision Cast.
Who's going to win Eurovision?
12 points.
Go to
Ukraine!
We will do the Ukrainian people and the rest of Europe really proud.
Welcome to Liverpool!
Eurovision Cast.
The ultimate backstage pass to Eurovision 2023 in Liverpool.
Join Nina, Daniel, Gunan and me, Moms,
as we bring you all of the news, views and gossip
from the greatest show on earth.
Hey guys, I'm Mae Muller. Please come and join our Eurovision family.
Oh, wow.
Eurovision Cast.
Listen on BBC Sounds.
To the Top on Radio 2.
Morning, Matt. How are you?
I'm very good, thanks, Gary.
Good. So you like to DJ and you do karaoke in your local area?
I do, yes, yes. I've been doing it for the best part of a year now. I've always fancied doing it, so ended up buying the gear. So, as they say, all the gear, no idea.
I'm sure you're fantastic. And your claim to fame is that you once delivered a pizza to Wayne Rooney's house.
Yes. I had a part-time job working for Domino's many years back. And yeah. I once got a ticket. I saw Wayne Rooney's name on it. I thought, that can't be the same one.
Yeah.
So I drove about 2 miles down the driveway and there he was in his pyjamas at the front door.
Really? Was he nice?
He was all right. He only gave me a £4 tip, though.
Ah.
There you go.
There you go. So, battle of the pool players today, because you play pool in your local league.
Yes, I do.
And apparently you're really good.
Well, I wouldn't say that. I once fluked my way into winning all my games in one season once.
Wow.
Don't ask me how, but I did do it. Apparently, it was unprecedented at the time.
Well done. Let's see if you can beat your fellow pool player. 12 points to beat. Feeling confident?
Kind of.
Okay.
We'll see in a minute.
Yeah, Steve was very confident before he got to his questions. Listen, good luck to you. I wish you a good round. Are you ready?
Thank you, Gary. I am.
Here comes your 10 to the top. Question one. Throughout their run of hits in the 90s, Dolores O'Riordan was the singer with which band?
That was the Cranberries.
Yes. Was the Cranberries. 2 points on the next question. In 1989, Depeche Mode had a top 20 hit with the song Personal What?
Jesus.
Yeah. Personal Jesus. For 3 points, in what year did Frankie Valli reach the top three with the title song from the film Grease?
1971.
1978, I'm afraid.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah, later than that one. So, you're back down to 1 point on this next question. Here's the intro to a top three hit from 1985, which gave this man his UK chart debut. What's his name? Who's that?
Is it Sidney Youngblood?
No, it's not. It's Colonel Abrams. Colonel Abrams, the song was Trapped. Still for 1 point. With which song did Wham make their top 40 debut in 1982? Out of time.
Young Guns.
Out of time, I'm sorry.
Oh.
Has to be within the 5 seconds. And it was Young Guns.
Oh.
I know. Brackets, go for it. Got to answer quicker.
Yes.
Still for 1 point. Goldbug scored a top three hit in 1996 with a reworking of which Led Zeppelin song?
Stairway to Heaven.
It was the other one, Whole Lot of Love.
No.
Yeah, but worth having a go.
No.
Still for 1 point. Complete the title of this 1972 T-Rex number one hit. Metal what?
Guru.
Is the correct answer. Okay, so you have 2 points on this next question.
I better play me Joker, I think.
So you have 4 points on this next question. Good luck. Which singer had top 10 hits in 2005 with the songs Crazy Chick and Call My Name?
No, sorry, Gary.
It was Charlotte Church.
Oh.
Oh.
Not doing very well, are you?
It's the way it happens sometimes. Two more questions to go. This week in 1991, Johnny Marr from The Smiths and New Order's Bernard Sumner had this top 10 hit, but under what group name? What's the name of that group?
Stage Fright here, Gary. I'm complete. It's on tip of my tongue.
I know. Electronic.
Yeah.
Oh, what a shame. Final question. Which music icon scored their final UK top 10 hit in January 2013 with the song Where Are We Now?
Wow.
That would be nope. David Bowie. Bowie. Well, I guess not your best day on the quiz, really, is it, Matt? No.
No, not really. I usually do better than that when I'm listening.
Yeah, I'm sure you do. And there were some stinky little questions there. And it's just the way they run, because if you can get a bit of a run going, then you can really build your points up. But sadly, that wasn't the case today. You got 4 points, and you get yourself a Radio 2 mug.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you very much.
It's been lovely speaking to you.
Thank you very much, Gary.
Have a lovely weekend, Matt. All the best.
Thank you. Cheers.
Cheers. And Steve Oliver in Chelmsford.
Hi, Gary. Hi.
12 points is the winning score today.
Yeah, I'm very surprised, I must admit. I mean, he had a good start. He got the first question right, which was better than what I did. And I thought, this is going to be tough. But He had a few questions that probably he would have got on another day, but it was just one of those things. And like you say, that's the way the cookie crumbles sometimes. So I'm pleased, very pleased.
It's what makes the quiz exciting and unpredictable, which is the way it should be. And at the end of the day, it's only fun. Steve, you get yourself a Radio 2 smart speaker.
Fantastic. That's brilliant. Thank you, Gary.
Well done. Have a fabulous weekend.
You too. Thank you.
Cheers. Take care. And that's it for 10 to the Top for this week. But, of course, the quiz will return next week. Bank holiday Monday. I'm here. And so is 10 to the Top. You fancy taking part? Send an email to 10tothetop@bbc.co.uk.
To the Top on Radio 2.
There you go. A whole week of quizzing has been and gone. How did you do? A pat on the back if you did well, but if it didn't go to plan, just listen again. You'll probably know the answers this time. Thanks for listening, and don't forget to hit subscribe on BBC Sounds.
BBC Sounds. Music, radio, podcasts.